that out, man. You get me, fam? That man's lived this thing. Certain people are not made for it. Certainly young, she's growing up, ain't made for this. Like, if you get nicked, you probably snitch. Or can't hack the perch or get caught lacking and that. You're just probably gonna fucking get stripped on camera or do something like shit, but like, I've seen it. You feel me? Get stripped or get banned out, this happens, innit? Like, you get me, for the young youths are a lot, man. You get me? Put down the knives.
The Artist TV, in association with Block 5 Entertainment, we're back. Man like Kidavelli, one of the Instagram live dons at the moment. Everybody's watching what he's on. Some are agreeing, some ain't, but everyone's got questions. So let's ask him.
Good, my brother, you feel me, fam? It's happy to be here today, because you feel me, man's here to talk on everything, because that's been going out on the media, you feel me?
Yeah.
So man's ready today, fam. Like, I'm ready for anything today, my brother, you feel me?
Well, let's get it cracking.
No mask or nothing, innit?
Yeah.
Straight, big face thing, you feel me?
Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to go through everything.
Yeah.
Everything that people want to know. Some of these things you might find ridiculous. Yeah. They don't matter. Somebody somewhere wants the answer.
Yeah.
So we're going to cover everything.
Yeah.
Let's start at the good, big man, because obviously there's some good, there's some bad, and there's some ugly in it.
Mm.
Like, why did you start doing Instagram Live? What was your reason for going up there on that?
Brother, I'll be real with you, fam. You see, with the Instagram Live, man started that from last year, fam. You feel me? Man never used to do no netting. You feel me? But when I came out of job, I just thought, you know what, last year, bruv, I jumped on Insta. It came to man, because when I was making the music now, doing tunes with Pac-Man, like, get me, getting doing videos with Pac-Man, Press Play, all these man, link up, like, started to blow up, you get me? So when I jumped on Insta, man was doing my thing, innit? The music thing, trying to find ways to promote man's tunes. Obviously, when it came to man, like, rah, like, it just come to man, you feel me, fam? So I was happy, fam, like, in a way, you're happy, innit? Because it's come, like, you're interacting with other fucking big artists, innit? It's cool, but in a way, like, it brought negativity as well, innit? But that negativity, man, could turn it into real shit, innit? But the reason that I jumped on Insta, I just came out of jail, you feel me? Like, man, I just thought, you know what, fuck it, let me just jump on this Insta thing, you get me? Like, just do the music thing. I was on it on the music thing, you get me? But it ended up going a different way as well, but it's still good with the music thing, you feel me?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Mm.
Okay, well, let's get on to what people see of you up there. Like, obviously, some people like that you're on. Some people don't. Some people say you're not all there. Mm. You're on some kind of medication. Mm. What's going on with that talk? Is Kidavelli taking any sort of medication? Is he alright?
Cuz, I won't even lie to you, fam. All that medication talk is bullshit. Because Kidavelli don't take no medication, you feel me? Kidavelli's been like this, you feel me? Man's just been naturally gassed from young, you feel me?
Yeah.
So whoever thinks man's on medication, they're on medication, my buddy, you feel me? Like, fuck them, cuz, like, what medication, my brother? You feel me? Like, no medication out here, fam, you feel me? Like, other people that's chatting shit about man, they're therefore on medication, fam, cuz me, I've just been a real nigga. Like, I can't be on medication, certain niggas might say this, but this is how I've been, you feel me?
Yeah.
No mental health from primary school, boy, you know like that? I was calm, but I was always in the gas thing, on the other hand, you get me?
Yeah.
But all the medication talk, I've never took no medication in my life, it's just me, you get me?
Okay. Well, let's get on to the next thing. Obviously, we're going to start this at the beginning.
Yeah.
You said that you're officially from Brixton.
Yeah.
Like, where in Brixton are you from? What part of Brixton was you rolling in?
I can't lie to you, when I was Brixton, innit? That was old school, you feel me? But now, man is from Elephant, innit? I'm from Elephant in Castle Tower. But back in the day, when I was young 28s, gas gang. I mean, young 28s, whatever, used to chill with the gas gang lot and whatever.
Mm.
Man, that's when I was Brixton, you get me? Man used to roll with Fields, I lived on Vassal Road, you feel me?
Yeah.
On Vassal Road, that's where man lived. I used to fuck with Fields and Town, but I mostly fucked them all Fields, man. You feel me?
Yeah.
So, that was it, fam, you feel me? Like, with that was it, innit? But I don't really rep Brixton, you get me? I don't rep Brixton, no more people might still see me as a bricky nigga, but on the other hand, I still go there and check certain man in the hood, you feel me?
Yeah.
I still go check a couple man in the hood, it's calm, you feel me? I know that the people that I rated, you feel me? Because okay. we're young 28s, like people that sacks and them man from 8 Boys, they know man. They was underneath us man, they were that tiny 28s, tiny PDC now. They carried on the team and our generation, blah, blah, you feel me?
Yeah.
Like in about 013, you feel me? Started the 061 thing, but that's it. I'm originally from Taba, not Elephant, but that was it, innit? Yeah, okay. Certain man know man anyways, kids came out, it's kid of Eddie. That was my new graph. I changed it from like what, 014 or something.
Yeah, so let us know. Why did you leave Brixton? Why did you move to Elephant?
Yeah, to be honest with you, it was just that family problems, innit? Like man moved over there. You know like when you move yard?
Yeah.
Because I've seen certain accusations, people might chat shit online about Bricky Reject. But how can I be a Bricky Reject for, yeah? If I still talk to certain members from the ends, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I might still talk to certain members and I go there, it's calm, bro. It's not and that, you get me? It's people think I'm even distance away from them, you get me? Mm-hmm. So the reject thing, no one from Bricky's ever said that in their life, innit? Like, but the reason I moved was because of whatever family. You're still living with your family there. They've moved, obviously, to their family, you get me? So that was it.
Okay.
And I just started trying to do my own thing. You feel me? I thought, you know what? Let me create my own gang. Like, you get me? Like, if I create my own gang, cool. And it worked out for me in the end. For me.
Mm. Yeah. Okay, but let's talk on something else that I've heard you say up there. I've heard you say that you've been through a lot in your life.
Mm.
So tell us, let us know, what have you been through? What things has Kid Aveli been through?
Fam, Kid Aveli's been through wars, fam. Like, you get me? If you know about Kid Aveli, then you know Kid Aveli's been through a lot, from Kid Kana to Kid Aveli, innit? Like, trust me, been through bear shit, fam. With the beef thing, going through struggles when I was younger, family problems, you get me? It's all been that, you get me? Gone through depression certain times, you feel me? Mm-hmm. Gone through depression about for like 3-4 months at one point, you get me?
Yeah.
Man's gone through depression, fought it, you feel me? Like, nothing was gonna bring me down. Like, man's been through wars of beef, I've only been touched twice, you get me? So everyone that says man's been touched, like, I've gone through wars, innit? Like, getting caught lacking, whatever, but I've done things to a lot of man, you feel me? No man can ever see Kid Aveli hasn't put in the work, because Kid Aveli is raw to the bone. You feel me? Raw niggas can relate, but with everything else like that, trust me, I've been through a lot. Like family issues, going through depression on the other side, like bare wars with people, with fake niggas as well, that's the shit I don't like, you get me?
Yeah.
All of that, just been through a lot, you get me? You falling out, but that's it, you get me, my brother? That man's been actually through a lot, but I'm happy at the end, things are starting to work out, you feel me?
Okay, you say you've been through a lot. Let's get into one of the things you've posted up there on your Insta Live. You put a post up there of you chasing down Harlem Spartans.
Yeah.
And it ended with you holding a bag with some arachis.
Yeah.
Now people's got speculations on that. For one, you never showed no Harlem Spartans in that footage. Secondly, most of the named Harlem Spartans are either in jail or they're making music money. They're not even running around the blocks in Kenton no more.
Fair enough.
So we want to know, which Harlem Spartans did you take that rucksack off?
Ah, cool. That's a perfect question, my brother, yeah? You see that video? It's not a new video, innit? But you see on YouTube, you can tell when the video come out, innit? That video came out when I come out of jail. It's like a year and a bit old now, you feel me?
Mm.
When it came out of jail and got revenge. Because them man there, they linked up with man's ops, you feel me? We've had passes, whatever. That they linked up with the Rock and the Roots, them pussies, innit? But like, it's a thing of where, cool, come out of jail that time, rid out of them. As you can see in the video, man had plats in it. Man's come out of the, come and came out of the jailhouse, went over there. That bag was, fam, whatever happened, bro, that's Little Dan's bag, SD, they're cool, innit?
Yeah.
That's going to be their big man, innit? But I'll be real, fam, that's going to say it on camera, he dropped his bag. Me and my nigga, two man up, him and these niggas left there, like, you get me? Pulled up on them. Brother. Pulled up on them, normal, four-door whip, cool, parked the car, see them, went to man's main block where they make videos and chased man up. Asked man, he from Harlem, get me? One of them obviously, he said, bro, yeah, blah, 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 we're from Harlem, cool. And then the rest of them was quiet. When he said from Harlem, yeah, cool, backed up the team, they clocked already who man was, you feel me? So we backed up the team, then man kept it stepping. Man ran for their life, man tripped, like, come on, fam. It's SDU, Little Dan's a joke, man, fam. Like, you get me? When I saw him at Spat Nation, he wasn't on fucking piss, fam. You get me? Him and these little six goons and that, before SA died, couple man see them at Spat Nation, they weren't on piss. They had to go and pull more reinforcements when I was up there, one up, ready to get a cracking with every man. You feel me? But he ran off and left his bag, fam. You get me? When we backed up the team, he ran into his friend dropped. So we picked up the bag, you feel me?
But what we will ask you is why we didn't see him in the footage. Where was he? Why didn't we get him?
That's what I'm saying. Because at that time, bro, man just come out of jail, you feel me? And I won't even lie to you, man, it's come out of jail, but I still had filmed it. Now, my nigga, obviously, this was one guy I used to chill with, but we're not bridges no more, innit? The youth showers, he was there with, man, you get me? People might know him as Shower S, whatever, you get me? He was there with, man. I remember at one point, when we backed up the team and they blew, man still chased after, man, you feel me? Man still ducked, man, down, fam, you get me? And then after that, because I was filming it, I must have dropped my phone. My phone dropped, you get me? I can't lie, these times I came out of jail, it was a bit of a sticky time. So the phone I had wasn't that great, you get me? So the phone's dropped, so man's had to go underneath the car to grab the phone. And they're coming back out of the block where they ran into, guy into bushes looking like they're getting something, they're just acting. So that's what happened. I had that footage, but it was definitely Harlem Spartans, you get me?
Yeah.
It was none of them have ever denied that's happened, you feel me? That I mean, that it's never happened. They know that it's happened, you get me? They've never denied about, oh, that's not true, because it was them. Because when it happened, a lot of GMs, like, pardon me, you get me? Man's got a bag in there, like, when he dropped his bag, so man's gonna take the bag, you feel me?
Yeah.
I'm thinking, man, I have something in the bag, you get me? Man's in the trap, cool. What's in your bag, brother? No wap, no swam, no food. So how does that make sense, my buddy, you feel me? Yeah. If you ain't got nothing in there, so man's took the bag, check the bag, brother. There's wrapped up Karachis and fucking condoms, my brother. That man actually got chased out, fam. We never do this for clout. Everyone knows, innit? That most GMs know already it was them because they never ever, like, denied anything. You get me? So that's a good look on that. You get me? But from other people viewing it, they might think, oh, yeah, this and that. But I'm happy because this is the first time I've heard that. You get me?
Yeah.
Because everyone knows that these men have been ducked down. You get me, brother? That man, don't joke. You fool me, G. That man ain't joke, man. You fool me, because that.
Yeah, so you're telling us that story's 100% official. So what do you say official to the people that are saying you're chatting long? All you done was take a little schoolboy's rucksack and kept it moving. Huh. What do you say to them, man?
You see what I say to them, man, bruv? What I say to them, man, is, bro, yeah? You man sucked your mum's, fam, because you man don't know, man. You fool me? Just remember that. Man doesn't know me from anywhere, fam. You get me? You know the history. Why am I going to run up on a little boy and take his back set? I say to all you motherfuckers, suck your mum, innit? Whoever's with, man, love to the supporters, innit? I respect the supporters, but to the fake niggas and haters, stuff this, fam, because you don't know the truth, but you still want to try to chat shit on man's name. Like, about a school kid, what, fam? Like, you know, like that, all that shit is nonsense, because bro niggas know that's true. They know in their heart it's fucking true, you feel me? Man ain't got time for that, to be making videos acting as if it's a school kid's thing. Well, my man often dropped his bag. Like, man didn't even ask my nigga showers. The nigga shower S, the showers guy, he's been on my lap. When we fell out, he's come on my lap saying, kid, like, he came and spoke to man on the level, you get me, fam? He knows, man, for putting in work. He was talking about the Harlem thing on man's lap. This was this time last year, you feel me? Like, so, what's all the talk about? He's come on my lap. This is the shit that should be going on YouTube, like, you feel me? Not all this dumb shit, fam. When it's the real truth, man talks, it's not going out there, fam. You feel me? So to everyone out there, suck your mum, fam. If you're with it, suck, fuck you, fam. You get me? Because you know the fucking truth, fam. You get me?
Okay, let's get on to the next story on that. Like, obviously, you're putting out footages. You put up a recent footage as well with someone being run down. But what people are saying is them footages are never clear. It seems like there's never anybody seen clearly in them footages.
Well, which footage is my brother?
The newest one you put up, you can't even see my man in that. You can't see none of the footages clearly on who the ops are. What do you say to that?
I would say to that, if you can't really see, then wear some glasses, go to Specsavers, cuz. You know what I'm saying, brother? If you can't completely see what's happened on the screen, then please, fam, Specsavers is there, fam. Sign up, go to the Specsavers team, because look, you can see on the camera clearly what's happened, innit? You can see on the camera clearly what's happened. You can see it up there. These people been chatting shit on Insta for time. You catch them riding up to my block, and then you get run up my ends. Man don't even deserve splashings. You feel me? Donny got smoked in his face, bruv. Like, come on, fam, back in his face. You get me? Like, come on, fam, I got run down the road and I ran for man's life. Left man screaming like a chicken, like a little fucking dog, fam. A chicken and a dog mixed together, you feel me? So, next time niggas' hearts need to be in it because everything that's happened is there. And people my ends know. You get me? These man here, the same niggas that's been there, it's the same niggas that chat shit on Insta, they're meant to be beefing. But then people are saying it's young G's or whatever. They're not young G's, fam, you get me? They're adults. They're over appropriate age, you feel me? You can get smoked, fam, you get me? If you're saying you're gonna do road, then what's the point, you get me? When it comes down to it, you're not doing that. You're just talking shit on Insta, thinking you're a bad man. So you're riding up on Insta, but you're not riding up in real life. So you can see clearly in the picture that, of course, it's ups. You get me? They rid out and got chased at the ends, innit? My nigga was there. I was there with my nigga. He's cool. You get me? He's a calm guy. He's a businessman. He ain't got time for this beef. He tried to obviously settle down everything and told him to dust up, or he knows what man's going to do, or kid's going to do this, blah, blah, blah. You feel me? Like, they know. You get me? So everything was confirmed. You get me? Everyone but the youth today, you told mama, man, fam, you done your thing, fam. You get me? Them man are not on piss. How can they ride out, coming across the road, screaming whatever, 6'3", rocking them? But when I catch you, but now, when I see you, when I approach you, you're on a different thing. You feel me? Like, how does that make sense, bro? Like, come on, fam. Like, it's mad. Like, it's upstairs. So the people that's chatting shit about that, they clearly know the truth. Like, everything's clear. You've seen what's happened in the team. What I'm seeing now, it's even on YouTube, my brother. You get me?
Okay.
Like, the whole of that team, my boy, let me explain to you. They've spent their whole life, like, rocking them 6'3", and spent their lives running away from the Mandem. This beef, I can't even call that beef, bro. I'm too on to beef these niggas. I'm too on job for them, me and my niggas. They take L's every single year, bro. You feel me? I don't even know how these men turn packers. You feel me? Like, we've touched enough of these youths, have been touched on roads, bro, like, but they don't show the same energy in real life. How many times have these men been caught and they've said they're from different ends, my brother? This is what niggas know. I want the real niggas that watch this to know what man's talking about, because real niggas in the ends, and my ends in Tabba, know what I want. You get me? Niggas are speaking these niggas from Burns as well. They know. They man are frauds, you feel me? They chat shit on Insta, cool. Their elders have been touched, brother. Look, this is what it is, yeah? People say young is whatever, yeah? I'm chasing down young is cool, bro. Their oldest have been touched. Middle age have been touched. And their youngest have been touched. Does that make sense? Brother, come on, fam.
Okay, mm-hmm. Let's get on to the next thing then.
Mm-hmm.
Right about now, you've said up there on Insta Live that you've been stabbed before.
Yeah.
Tell us how many times and where.
Cool. Bro, man's been stabbed twice in my life, my boy, yeah? One was in the back of my neck, bro. That was in 2009. So people that are still bringing that up here about a dirt that's happened in 2009, I can't take man serious, but like, man need to wake up, fam, you feel me? Like, 2009, that's 10 years ago. Do the maths. When come on, brother, like, that's 10 years ago, you feel me? Do the maths, brother, like, I can't take that serious. That's in 2009, brother. I got revenge, like, so man's good, you feel me? I can't complain, fam. 09, that's calm. And then you got wiped up in the marsh and Belmarsh as well. Trust me, fam. And after he stabbed, man, he was screaming. This was on that 09. You had, what was it called? You know, what's it called? MSN. Was it called MSS or MSN? What's it called? MSN days, innit? That thing, MSN or whatever it's called. It was them days, whatever it's called, if I'm saying it right. If I'm not saying it right, then cool. But people will know, MSN. That was that, like, the new, that was that, like, the Instagram back then times. You feel me? Bonnie was saying, was in a group chat, all of us. Bonnie said he didn't mean to stab, man. He's telling other gang members he didn't mean to stab, man. That's a coward shit. You're a coward, brother. Where the fuck are you now, fam? You're a coward. You feel me? That's it. Once, man's been splashed. You feel me? That was then. The second time, but in 014, I can't even class that as a stabbing, but I still got stabbed, innit? So, bruv, but I only got that. I didn't even need to get stitches, but it's a leg shot. Leg shot, my brother. Donnie could have done a lot. He's talking that he wanted to kill man, this and that. What did you do? Leg shot. Legs, my brother. You get me? I don't want to start taking off my chances, but that's a leg shot, you feel me? Like, they had to get glued up, my brother.
So your condition after both of them was calm? Everything was calm?
Brother, it was calm. I got stabbed around my neighbor in the neck. Told him, brother, you couldn't believe that I've even been stabbed in my neck. You know what I'm saying, my brother? He couldn't even believe it. Because he thinks when you get stabbed in your neck, you're choking, you know, like that. But fam, I've walked to the hospital, my brother. I've called my brethren. Not hospital, sorry. I've called my brethren. You get me? I've called my nigga. I got stabbed in my neck. He don't believe me, I've been stabbed in my neck. Cool. He's come and picked me up. I've gone to the ends, walked to the ends. I was walking at that in my body warmer. I remember I had a red Adidas shirt and a body warmer on. I had my body warmer like this walking. I started to feel the pain afterwards. Cool, I went to hospital. I was only in hospital for like an hour and a half, 2 hours, and I was out. Well, so fuck you, my brother. But I rate him because it was a dirty neck shot, but fuck it, you get me? That's life, but all that real niggas get touched, but it's what you do back, you feel me? Most man don't retaliate. Man done my thing back, you get me? Whatever I'm talking big, fuck it, you get me? The youth's a coward, you feel me?
But you yourself, being a man who's been touched with a knife and knows what goes on, how do you feel about the fact that when you're up there on Insta, you're talking about you walk around with your Rambo all day, all night, it's either be touched or get touched?
It's that. Because it's true, innit? I've got my ting on me. Like what I said, the video you saw, man had my ting. That's what happens when you lack. Like some of them dully youths as well, they've been caught slipping. Shots, Don Grimms have had nightmares on Tabard Street times two. Bear man, you get me? They're going to start talking bear news, but they know. This, I'm just replying back to the questions that you're asking me and what's going on Insta. You fool me, my brother? That they've been touched, so it's cool. So I know I've got bare beef, so I need to walk around with my ting. You feel me? I've got my ting. I need to roll my ting. Because when I don't have my ting, I feel paranoid. Because you feel me? I don't feel safe. Because I know I've got bare beef. Because I'm bait everywhere I go. Everywhere I go, but people show me love in bare different ends. You feel me? But that's why I still got to have my Rambo. Because you don't know who could come to you. They could know your face. And just want to probably take up cameras and film you, you get me?
Yeah.
It's happened before, someone tried to come out and pull out their phone. Brother, it ended up bad for me.
But you remind us, how long have you spent in your life in jail so far?
Well, I've spent probably most of my teenage years, brother. Since probably end of 2011 till like now, I've been in jail, brother. This is the longest I've been out of jail for, like a year and a half, you get me?
Yeah.
A year and a bit. Man's been out of jail a year and a bit, fam. Like, fam, it's long, fam. I can't lie, I spent all my teenage years in jail, fam. I've done a hell of jail time, innit? I've been in there with probably every single end of the name, you feel me?
Yeah.
Been in jail for a lot of people, so you know how it goes, my buddy, you feel me?
Yeah, so let me put a question on you now. You walking around with your knife all the time can only end two ways. Either the feds get you, or you end up doing a madness to someone, or they do a madness to you. Either way, if you're still alive, it's jail time. You're going to be sitting in jail for years. Is that what you want?
I'll be real with you, my buddy, yeah? You see me? I don't really need to talk certain things, innit? It's all ugly questions, my buddy, yeah? But it's cool. I'll answer it in a certain way, my buddy, yeah? At the end of the day, it's killed, innit? If you ain't got your ting and your guy sees you, he's going to do something to you. He's going to be happy that you left. If I see him, if he's lacking, I'm going to be happy that he's left. That's how the whole thing goes, you feel me? Like, you feel me? That's the whole thing. But at the end of the day, brother, on the other hand, with the jail thing, I understand what you're saying, innit? With the jail thing, brother, that's the risk you got to take. It's like doing anything. If you're doing something, obviously, illegal, whatever you're doing, bro, you're taking a risk, innit? You got to take that risk, bro. You feel me? Man, take risk and prosper, you feel me? So, I'd rather not die, I'd rather go to jail than die. You feel me? I'm not afraid of death, you get me? I'm not afraid of death, fam. Niggas have come to man and flopped. You get me? Niggas have come to man and tried to do whatever they're saying they're gonna do and flopped. You feel me? But that's how it goes, brother. You feel me? Cause that, you know what I'm saying? But that's how it is, fam. At the end of the day, the jail thing, I ain't trying to go back to jail, innit? That's how it goes, innit? But man still gotta do my thing, fam. You get me? Like, fuck that, cuz you get me? I ain't letting a man kill me before, man, fam. You might as well try and pack before me. How about that? It's kill or be killed. I'm focused on my music. See, right now, I've done a lot of things on the road. Niggas know, innit? Like, man's done a lot of things, you feel me? That's it, you feel me? Like, right now, like, it's long, you feel me? Because all this beef thing, like, it's long, innit? But man will still get my down. I'm focused on money and music. That's my main priority. But beef, I'll still do that.
Okay, let's get on to something else.
If a man comes to man, whatever, it's cool, innit? We can still do this thing, we can still take it there, innit?
Okay, let's get on to the fact that you're real popular up on Insta Live.
Yeah, my brother.
There's about three of you that are. But don't get it twisted, the feds are watching these Insta Lives.
Nah, it's true.
So people are saying that you need to know yourself because feds are watching and all you're doing is baiting yourself up. What do you say to that?
To be honest with you, bro, I don't really give a fuck. Fuck the feds, innit, fam? If you're not coming to arrest, man, don't come to my yard. And it's happened by a numerous amount of times. We're known, we're 061, fam. We're known as bandits, you get me? We're known as satin at the narcos, fam, you get me? People, niggas know, we don't need to boast about that. That's why I don't talk about most of them things. The whole team is known to the Jakes, you feel me? I'm known big to the Jakes, whatever, innit? But it's what they can prove, you feel me? But I ain't trying to move bait because at the end of the day, I'm smart. I know what I'm doing, you feel me? I know what I'm doing. So if man are saying that and drawing me up, you're drawing yourself up too. Whether I show a bait face, I'm not scared to show my face. Why am I hiding my face for, fam? Well, I put my face in a mask. I ain't got no band. Unless you're banned or whatever. It's long. But at the end of the day, bro, fuck them, man. If they ain't got nothing on, man, don't talk to man. You feel me? Feds can't come and chat to man, fam. But at the end of the day, how the thing goes, my G. You feel me?
Okay. Well, let's get on to the other side of that. The side of the people that are watching you. There's certain people that are watching you up there just to mock what you're doing. They feel like it's a joke. What do you say to them people?
Brother, I say to them people, you're the fucking joke, you feel me? Because me, I've progressed, but I've got someone managing me in music, and I'm working now with one of the biggest producers, you feel me? That I'm doing my thing, I let my music talk, because they see me progressing. It's been that from time, innit? People have always hated, but to the people that don't like, I'm still progressing though, because there's real niggas that still like, man. People might think I've got no fans because I get hate on Instagram Live. But bro, it's Instagram Live because I still get love probably in their own ends. Everywhere I go, I get love, bro. You feel me? I got girls coming up to me. Mandem, civilians, uni youths, whatever. Big men, big women, you get me? Inbox me and they still share my thing, you feel me? But the Instagram thing, they're all fans deep down. Come on, bro. They're fans, innit? Man, I'm fans, innit? But they just have to get verbal, like, they just chose that whatever happens. I know how the thing goes, innit? Like, by the end of the day, whoever's chatting shit, my brother, fuck them, innit? Because I'm still progressing, my brother, you feel me? Because certain people would have thought I'd have quit, but I haven't quit for nothing, you feel me? I haven't quit for nothing, because most men that's been talking shit, whatever, on this Insta thing, they can't show their face, my brother. Obviously, forget the ops, I know my ops is face, but for other men that's talking shit on their real accounts and fake accounts, brother, if you can't even show me your face, am I meant to take you serious, my brother? Am I meant to take man serious? That fam, really come out here and do something to man. Come and say it to my face, fam. Because when man gets seen in the flesh, man ain't that, you feel me? Like, come on, brother, that's so fuck all of them, man.
Okay, let's get on to the next part regards that. Obviously, you've shown certain road movements on Insta. You've just told us that you're on shit and there's situations that have happened in your past. But there's still people that have seen those footage, heard you talk on Insta, and they're still saying you're some fake roadman. Because if you was real, you don't need to chat on nothing. You don't need to be up on Insta showing us your knife. You don't need to be telling us who you run down. You're just doing your thing and you're off. What do you say to them people?
Cool, it's cool, brother, yeah? You see me, I've never been a guy that boasted, my guy, about anything, innit? I've never done this neck thing, brother, since then. Before, it was just strictly music. It's cool. But when I jumped on this neck thing, if my next man's drawing me out, why can't I say something back? You can say something to me, but what? I can't say nothing back? How does that make sense, my nigga? To you, does that make sense, my boy? Sometimes you've got to explain your situation. When I explain my situation, apparently I'm a verbalist. You feel me? Because I'm nothing like a fake world, man. It's only that trolls, that fake niggas, that will make fake accounts. Well, you'd be surprised sometimes people on fake accounts, it's probably your ops or people you know. You feel me? I can't take that serious because when real gang members holler at me, bro, they know man from time. But I just decided to go down my own road and do my own thing with my own section. That's different. When they say that man, they know me is not a fraud. they know me as putting in work. There's been a few people that's come on my live and said certain things I've done. I wasn't happy about that because they technically baited me out on Insta, talking about shit went down. You feel me? But it's a good thing that never ended up on YouTube. That was like last year, November, December. But fam, man's never been a fake bold man because fake bold man where?
Fake bold man where, fam? You man are fake. If I'm a fake bold man, how am I a fake bold man if I'm out here putting in work? If I do put in work, I put in work, fam, and now I'm just focused on my money and music, but I'm still out here. Any man come and approach me, come and approach me and do your thing. I guarantee you, you can back up whatever. If you try to back up your phone, you already can't even put that on UK Joe News, fam, because it's going to show me banging up. You're going to look like a joker. You get me? So man's never been a fake bold man. Fake bold mans wouldn't make posts. If I was a fake bold man, I won't be doing music. I'd do my music, cool. Whatever, do, try and do my thing for money to make my living, cool. You get me, to live. But so how can I be a fake bold man if I actually show things? I've done enough snaps, bold, that for the past year that you know yourself.
But you know yourself, brother. Like, I've done enough snaps on a lot of people's blocks, chasing man down. Certain videos have been shut down from YouTube. There's been more serious content that's been put on YouTube. So I can't be a fake bold man if I'm really living this and people know that I live it. People I grew up with know. But just when it comes to social media, but it's the media, innit? The media is always just chat bare shit. You feel me? It's just chat bare shit, fam. Because if man, how can I be a fake nigga if I really do my thing? You get me? I'm really like, most things I'm rapping about, like, come on, I've done it all on my Snap. Cool. I don't even need to do the Snapchat thing. More time, I don't do that. I only do that there and there when I feel to. But I've still lived up to what I was saying in my bus.
Okay.
So, no fake bold man, fam. They're the fake bold man because you see them, they got nothing to do with their lives, brother. They wanna be, well, they wanna be gangsters, but they can't make it, you feel me? Because everyone, these same niggas that probably chat shit, bro, are the same niggas that will chat to me and ask me to be 061. How can I be 061? The thing's popping up. Sending me requests on inbox. Let me be 061. How can I be 061? Actually going up there trying to prove themselves to be 061. But I've always been a real nigga. Get me? I always stay a true nigga to the death. You feel me? Fuck the fake shit, bro. Real nigga.
So let's get onto your face now. Your face is fake, big man, let's be real.
Now, of course.
You're out there for a lot of madnesses with all these different posts. The way things are spread on the internet, you can never control that now. You'll never be able to take everything down. So what happens to when you become 30, 40, 50, 60, and you've changed your way of life? People will always see this part of your life's journey. You can't escape it now. What do you feel about that?
Bro, that's a fucking mad question still. I can't lie to you, bro. You see, if I was at 50 or 40, fam, yeah? Mine would be a different, I would look different. You feel me? You'd be different, but you get me, fam? I'm just like, you're gonna stay how I am for the rest of my life till I die, fam. You get me? I wanna progress. I just wanna see myself living, obviously, innit? I wanna win and prosper in life. Like, you get me? That's my main goal. But when you're 40, 50, bro, I ain't trying to be that people that AC. You think I'm trying to be that AC's age on the net doing all that shit?
But what I'm saying is it's spread out so much that it don't matter what you're doing, somebody's got that on their page. What do you think of them people that have spread your footages?
Wait, say that again. Well, what footages, my brother?
All of them. Like, you can go up there and watch all your footages on other people's pages.
Okay. I just see it, my brother. It's they helping man out, innit? Because they tried to bring me down, but it's helped me get out there. Regardless, I was already known for the ting, but they're boosting my career. All these niggas that say it, man, I'm down and fucking, like, thought man won't make it, man has made it. And I promise you, fam, it's gonna be bigger, fam. Remember that, fam. Remember that, bro. Like, you get me? So, like, fam, like, you know, like that, like, they can say that, innit? But man's not gonna be at 40 years old, time, fam. I'll probably have a million to it.
Yeah.
Get me? You won't see me on Instagram. You probably see me there. Right now, man's young, innit? Man's 25 now. It's cool. But man's an adult now. You get me? Man's a big youth now. Man's growing. Get me? I'm going to be from five for the next 5 years. I'm going to be 30. But in the next 5 years, I want to be on bigger levels. I believe in myself, innit, fam? That in the next 5 years, trust me, fam, I'll be and bigger things, bro.
Yeah, but how will you feel when you get onto them bigger levels and you're doing your thing, you've got a couple of kids, you've got a wife, you've got money coming in, everything's nice, and then one of your kids clicks up on the YouTube and they see a video of their dad that someone else has got on there. What are you going to feel then?
To be honest with you, my kids will respect me because my kids will know at least mum was a somebody, not a nobody, you feel me? They'll respect that because my kids know, right now, the way my kids love, man, bro, I found they're only one, brother. I'm having a conversation like I'm talking to you right now with a 1 year old kid. That's how intelligent they are. Do you know how intelligent they are? I've been testing them in a lot of things. They won the turn one on the 16th of June, you feel me? Like, if my kids click on that, my kids will always love me. My kids will never feel a certain way about me. They're going to fucking love me to the death. If they're how they love me now, they're going to love me. At least they're going to know my dad was out there. They're going to get respect because of me. They'll carry on my legacy whenever I'm dead, you feel me? So, yeah.
Okay, this is a real talk interview. And then no real talk interview if we don't talk about the AP. The footages have been up there. People are saying your AP's fake, Big Mum. You're putting it up there for a couple of seconds. You're not showing us the whole thing. Where's the AP now, Big Man? I want to see that to let them know it's official.
To be honest, my brother, that's a good question. You actually brought up this question, brother. I'll be real with you. I should have brought the AP, you get me? I should have brought the AP to just show everyone, but it doesn't make no difference, bro. Listen, I've bought the AP, cool. I've got a fake AP. Am I dumb enough to go on InstaLive and show off with a fake AP, my brother? Cool. I've gone on AP. Do you know how many times, my brother, I've zoomed into the AP? It's probably on YouTube. I've seen it twice, two, three times on YouTube, my nigga. You feel me? So how can my AP be fake? How can my AP be fake, yeah? If you can see it. Like, you can get APs, the same AP you can see. Check online or go to the shop, whatever, go to whatever jewelry shop, you're going to see the same AP. I can give you my AP, go there and check. So all these men talking about the AP, they don't know about jewelry, my brother. You feel me?
Yeah.
How can it be fake? How can it be fake, bro? If I wore that around real ballers, like ballers, I know real plugs and jewelers that I know. Real jewelers and my plugs have said, bruv, come on, fam, like, you get me? How can I wear a fake AP? That's what I say. It's all a bandwagon, by the way. Once one man said the thing, you see with me what I've clocked. One person will make a rumor because they're all haters. They want to be little girls, yeah, whatever, and that. Want to jump on the thing and just chat shit that is fake. They know it's real, but they'll say, of course, it's fake because they don't like that. You feel me?
Yeah.
But how does that make sense? If the AP is real, I've heard that wrong. Real ballers and jewelers have clocked it's fake. Do you know one thing here that they like? You know what it is? Well, I didn't like to do this. But now, because you told me that, my brother, I might start having to take screenshots of everything. You feel me?
Yeah.
I might have to take screenshots of everything because at the end of the day, certain jewelers on Insta, whatever in that, certain jewelers that everyone, whatever, gets jewelry off of, they holler me and they watch my thing and they watch me and say, I don't know why people say that your AP is fake when it's real.
So let us know.
They've tagged bare jewelers and everything I wear, they'll say this because it looks like a similar thing to our next website. But that website cats the same fucking jewelry from my next thing. They call me, they show me jewelry, like my Savage chain, yeah? People are saying I got it from this website. Cool. How is that the same thing? When you look at the picture, it's completely two different things to my thing. Whatever the website they're saying about my chains is different to that, my brother. When you look at the thing, it's different. I ain't got time to take that. It still blings, my thing shines.
Okay, so let us know, how much is that AP worth?
Fam, that AP is worth like 15 bags, my brother. You feel me?
Yeah.
You can't even see it online yourself. It's worth 15 bags, bro. You feel me? So, if man don't wants to chat shit, you know yourself, if you look at it, it's worth 15 bags.
Okay. So, let me ask you this. Let's get it straight. We all want nice things. Like, don't get it twisted. We all want an AP watch if we can get it.
Nah, that's it.
But right now, big man, how important in your life is having a watch over the normal, everyday things of life? Like, obviously, making your way through life, there's bills.
Nah,
how important it is for you to sit with an AP but not pay your bills?
Well, the bills get paid, innit?
Yeah.
I still live in, that's why I still have a roof over my head, you feel me?
Yeah.
Bills get paid, and I have an AP, my brother. So, what else can I say, my buddy? You get me?
Yeah.
That it's there, bills get paid, I've got an AP. People know it's real, but they say it's fake because they're hating. So, you get me? I know how the game works, but innit? It's only fake niggas you've cut out or whatever that will say certain things like that. Because most people inbox me saying they want to be that man.
Yeah.
You give me verbal, but you say you want to be that man. They say to me, I'm just doing it to fit in, my brother. But then you're just spreading out bare rumours. That's why you don't trust them niggas there. I'm smart. You can't trust them niggas there because the bills still get paid and you've got an AP. I'm not a fake nigga, G. And I'm not rich. You get me? Man's not rich, man. Man's not Rick Cross on that end, but man's trying to be on that stage. You feel me? Yeah. Man does my thing. I maintain and stack. You feel me?
But let me ask you, how important is it for you to have an AP? Like, what does that make you feel like when you're rolling around with a watch?
Cool. Let me tell you something. Because you earned it. You had sleepless nights for it, innit? You earned that shit. So everything I stunt with, I earned it. Mm. I earned this motherfucking shit, fam. Have you fucking earned it? Like, if they earned it, my brother, you know what I'm like? Have you worked hard and had sleepless nights going to sleep at 4 o'clock in the morning for months? You feel me? Like, I earned this motherfucking shit. You get me? I earned it. You get me? I worked hard for it. I earned this shit. So whatever I work hard for, I'm happy to stunt with. So whatever I stunt with, people say it's fake, when it's not fake, my brother. You get me? Man don't have to prove nothing. Show me this, show me that. Well, show me what? I'm going to show you my middle finger or my fucking wappy dickhead. You feel me? That's what you need to fucking see, fam. You know that? Show me this, show me that. Suck your mum, fam. That's what you need to do. Suck your mothers. You feel me? But that's fake. How can it be fake? Ah, come on, fam, man. We've gone through this too many times, bro. You know what I'm saying, brother? Like, it's mad, fam. You feel me?
Okay, well, let's get on to something you need to clean up. Because like you say, the AP's real, you don't want to hear that chat no more. But what people are saying is if your AP's real and you're nice with an AP on your wrist, are some of your videos done in a trap house? Because the chair and the wallpaper is a madness. Like, why would you just leave that like that?
Fam, I can't lie to you, yeah? Obviously, see all that wallpaper situation and that, yeah, fam. Obviously, it's a wallpaper, my brother, innit? But I can easily get that fixed, like, you feel me?
Mm.
Like, everything works in process, you get me? These men talk about that. They don't know man's background, innit? You get me? The shit man does in my life, fam, you get me? That man has to do certain things and that. But it's cool. I can say, yeah, the wallpaper is hanging out, Gene. Probably two pieces of my room in my bedroom and the fucking living room. It's karma, by the way, innit?
Yeah.
People do that to just try to drag you, but fuck them, cuz. You get me? They're probably living worse than the man. They're probably living in a real bando. My house is not a bando because I have a flat screen. I have two flat screens in my fucking household. I have a Skybox. I have a P3. I have a fucking, even a P3's old, but I still got a fucking console. And I've got a DVD player, but it's not a problem. You feel me? So, obviously the wallpaper's there. It's cool, fam. The wallpaper thing's mad, innit? That's a bit mad, but fuck them, man, innit, fam? It's cool. Because that can get fixed, you get me? But it's that, like, because that don't prove nothing. You can have like £1 million and your yard can look mad. How you are you to judge me? You know that? You're not fucking God, fam. You're not the fucking devil, fam. You're not God, fam. Who are you to judge me on my fucking life just because I have that? You don't know my surroundings. If I got always show my surroundings, no. Man, I'm even at pigs, fam. FBI informants are saying, why the fuck do you want to see my surroundings? Yes, wallpaper's hanging up. What, fam? You get me?
Mm. Uh-huh. Okay.
Obviously, shit will come with sort of progress, innit?
Yeah.
Shoe shape, man, obviously, whatever, the wallpaper, cool, fam, but like, they probably live with most of them, man. They probably got like 100 fucking wallpapers hanging off their fucking thing. So, explain that, you feel me?
Okay.
Oh, cuz, come
on. Pass that, yeah. Let's get on to this now.
Yeah.
Obviously, the AP's rule, you're telling us.
Mm.
You're living nice with that. You've got belts. We've seen you with belts in your footage. We've seen you with garms in certain pictures and that. But people are saying, all that show money. As man like Kid of Benny stacked away the money for a rainy day, or you just got that here today, gone tomorrow money?
It's to be honest with people, as I've said, innit, but I'm not rich, innit? Man's trying to be rich, you feel me? Man's not rich, I'll come on a road thing. Man's not rich, but I maintain and stack, you feel me? Man has to do this thing, fam. Man's got kids out here, cuz. You feel me? So, man's got two twins that turn 1 year old on the fucking 16th this month of June. We're in June, you get me? So, you get me, fam? So, man, just do my thing, fam. I'm trying to do my thing, people hate on, man. You get me? Even when man's not posting, the only reason why I started posting up things is because people just chat shit. I just thought about one day, you know what? I don't do this boasting thing. Let me just boast for a bit. Cool. In the past month, 3 weeks to a month, I showed man them probably about seven, probably about 5 to 7 bags. You feel me? That I'm really out there working hard for my thing. I didn't even want to do that. But every day has been different sets of bands. You get me? So, I don't know what all the talk is about, but like, you get me, fam? Like, people just talk shit. This is what they don't understand, innit? Kid the belly this, kid the belly this, kid the belly is a real nigga. Kid the belly don't lie. I'm trying to be rich. You get me? I'm trying to make music and blow and make satin out of me. You get me? Not be that bums that set a man. You get me? Yeah. This is the only hope. You get me? Once I hit the music wave ball, start eating my bread, that's when man will be laughing. You fool me?
Yeah.
But right now, man's trying to work hard to get to that stage. You get me? Man's got to do things, fam. Nothing's free out there. You get me?
Yeah.
Nothing's free, fam. Man's got, you got to work hard for it, you get me, bro? Right? You got to pay for everything, you feel me?
Yeah, I feel that. Mm.
So let me talk to you now about forget Insta Live. Turn that off for a minute. Talking no more about the music. We want to know what you are. What is Kid Aveli when there's no Insta Live and there's no music? What sort of man are you? What do you like to do? What's going on with your life?
Cool, you see Kid Aveli, bro, he's a real nigga. Kid Aveli's still real on Insta. And real in real life, you feel me? Insta, yeah, that's cool, that's whatever you do, blah, 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 yeah. But real niggas don't mean the flesh, I'm a real nigga, bro. I still do things. I try to benefit myself. I go studio. I've got my manager, I think I'm a manager, bro. I've done hella snaps out there in certain restaurants that a certain man can afford to go to. Man, I'm spending £200 on a fucking munch. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, man, walk out of there happy, fam. I'm spending £200 on a munch. You get me? Kid Aveli, get me, bro. Stu Jones does this music thing, cool. Links people, whatever. You get me, fam, got youths. Link my youths, do my thing, you feel me?
Yeah.
I always help people out.
But what do you like in life? Like, what are your things that you like? What's the things that make you feel like, yeah, you know what, today was a good day?
Cool. Fair enough. That's a good question, still. I would say Gan Studio and that, buddy. You get me?
Yeah.
Gan Studio and getting someone to holler me to go on a fucking date. Coming to make me sign papers, that's what will make my day. You get me? If obviously cool, that's what will make my day. If someone called man, told man come sign their papers for a label.
And yeah.
Even one of them in the studio, that makes me happy and all things like that, and building new links and making me blow and live life, you feel me?
Yeah.
That's Kid Aveli in the day-to-day life. Kid Aveli fam is always busy, you feel me? Trying to benefit my life. I work hard to get to where I want to be. So
yeah.
Day to day life, Kid Aveli still raw. Raw niggas know I'm raw, you get me? That's why people out there, every ends I go to show me love, you feel me?
Yeah.
Because day to day, what I like my brother is doing this music thing. I enjoy myself in the studio, you feel me?
Yeah.
Studio life, doing things, trying to be on that, things that Kenny All-Star and that from. I'm trying to be on that. Kenny All-Star, Link Up TV behind bars with Joey Clipstar and that, you feel me?
Yeah.
Fumes engineer thing and that. Well, come on, bro. Come on, brother. Tim Westwood ordered that, bro.
So why do you feel now that they ain't calling you? Why ain't you on none of them yet?
Bro, that's a good question. I really don't know why I'm not on one of them. But now, they've seen some of them. Obviously, they probably see my things. When people that showing them my things. I don't want to talk about certain things, brother, innit? But God, certain things, brother, they know the things, innit? When it's time, they hopefully they come to my innit?
Mm.
I pray that they come to my. You get me? They've seen it. They know I've gone. Both. But I think the reason why they might not be coming might be to do with certain things that's probably getting said about man out there, you feel me?
Yeah.
That might be the reason, getting said about man. But I know them man, they're still cool with it because they know man is out here still doing my thing.
Yeah.
I'm out here still making music. Like none of this shit that says me about Insta has brought me down, you feel me? So, like, you get me? They should be taking man on these things because I like them, man. Like Westwood, Kenny, all these, man. I like them, but at the end of the day, it should have brought my own family. Get me? But shit happens, innit? You gotta start from somewhere, bro, innit? Build up your team because, brother, if they gave me whatever it is at Westwood Crib Session or behind bars or whatever, Kenny all start mad about bars thing, I'll smash it, my brother.
Yeah.
Tell but me. Like you're saying, Big Mac, the Insta life is getting you out there, but it's also dampening certain things. So what I'm saying to you is, what is the future with the Insta Live? Are you going to still keep doing it? Are you hooked on it? Because it's like you say, there's the good and the bad. And the bad seems to get spread more than the good.
Nah, I fool you, my brother. You see, at the end of the day, my brother, I fool what you're saying, eh? The good spread, obviously, that's what it is. The bad always gets out there more, innit? The Insta Live shit, man's looking to cut that shit, you get me? More time I have breaks, man, I can be on Insta Live, whatever, this couple of days, blah, 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 and I have a cut in it. But man's just looking to cut it all in it. It's full of idiots, bro, you get me? I ain't trying to be an idiot, like, on Insta Live, with people just talking bare shit, you feel me? Man, I want to be seeing love on my team. Love always comes, set on my show respect, but I get love in inboxes, whatever, people tag me on shit on Insta, Snap, Twitter, whatever, innit? But to be honest with you, bro, it's long, innit? The Insta Live thing, it's getting long, fam, because it's just full of bare verbalists, you feel me? That's why I cut it down sometimes. Sometimes I come on it, but I still come on it because it's me. You get me? Mm-hmm. I'm just with me, fam. Like, I pay for my phone contract, brother. Do you pay for your phone contract, you fucking faggots, fam? Like, most of these faggots don't do that. I can afford to come on Instagram when I fucking want to, fam, you get me? I come on Instagram when I want to, you feel me? That's it, bro, come on. But that's how it goes, but to be honest with you, bro, the main question is, brother, I ain't even trying to be on this Insta Live by next year, man. Yeah. This Instagram Live shit, fuck with the verbal thing. It's over with that now. Most people have been trying to draw me out to do this verbalist thing. Because they want me to see me, like, flopping my life, sitting there, giving verbal. That's not me, brother. I'm trying to be making moves. But you get me? But the Instagram thing is cool, fam. I don't mind it, fam. I can still go on Insta. Man's promoting my thing, you feel me? Man's promoting my thing as a real nigga. You feel me? Days I promote my music all the time. I'm an artist. You know what I'm saying? I'm an artist and that, bro. Sometimes you go on there and get drawn out. It's how it goes, my brother. You feel me? It's happened to every other artist, my brother. You feel me? But niggas just try to bear shit. Like, fam, you get me, fam? Because they ain't doing nothing bad with themselves, brother. You feel me? Come on, fam.
Okay. Mm. Well, let's get into the drawing out now. Mm. Because we have to be real in this interview. And you've been drawn out in a different way than some of the others that are at the top like you. Mm-hmm. Because one of the things that has been drawn out on you is you have a lot of connection with women. You have one-to-ones with women. There's things where they say stuff, you say stuff. Mm. You've talked things about young women as well. And it's got to now where people are saying that Kidavelli is a pervert. They're posting that up. When you go on live, there's people putting that in the comments.
Yeah, cool ball.
Now you tell us, how does that sit with you?
Cool ball. Let me tell you something. See, all that pedo shit is fucking absolute ball. Like, you see, I'm going to stand up for this, my brother. You see, all that pedo shit, bro, yeah? Whoever is talking about pedo this, you're a fucking pedo, fam. Because for you to ever put that on someone's name, you're a fucking joke, brother. You're a joke. You fool me? You're a joke. Because at the end of the day, who have I fucked, brother? You know that? If I fuck someone that's young, not one time that girl has ever came and said that I fucked her. So who have I fucked, my brother? You fool me? That's what I say to them. Explain to me who have I fucked. Do you know how the rumor started, my brother? I'm going to explain to you, G, we're probably going to go on for 10 minutes today, my G, about this. I'm going to explain the whole story, innit? This is how it started, bro, yeah? Cool. There was a young girl called Angela, yeah? Called Angela, my brother, yeah? She was fam. Obviously, she liked my music. You feel me? The girl liked my music. Cool, I used to give her advice. Don't do this, blah, 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 this and that. She used to have madness, whatever, in a college, whatever she was. I used to tell her, brother, cool. Just chill that for me. I used to give her a dash and that's the music. She was always tagging me in my story. Every tune I put, every freestyle I put in my post, she was a Kid of Vels fan. She's a fan. But when she's young, what I said to the girl was, bruv, support the music. You feel me? She's already said that. Niggas have gone on her fucking live or whatever, or inbox there, and she said the same thing. You feel me? But these men, because they're so haters, they're against, man. Fuck them, innit? I don't care about them. I've got real love for my real supporters. They're not supporters. They're fake niggas, innit? They're just fake niggas, man. Fuck them. But they've gone now and asked her, and she said, no, I've never fucked her. That's what I see. This was all last year, my buddy. You feel me? Cool. That's how it started. And then they're upset because the girl never admitted. Like, you get me? The girl admit, like, the girl said, I've never talked to her. Innit? That's what she said, yeah? Cool. Up to now, the Angela girl has never, ever said nothing like that. She said she liked my music, cool. I spoke to her one or two times, but I've never moved to the girl. So who the fuck can I have fucked? Who the fuck have I fucked, man? Mm-hmm. Who have I fucked? Who have I fucked, man? I've got kids, man. My baby mum's 28 years old, fam. You think I've got time to be fucking young kids? Are you mad, fam? Like, fuck that, bro. Like, fuck that, fam. Like, if man's really onto it, I come on, fam. Niggas just chat shit. Now, like, peed away from that. Like, I've never, ever in my life fucked any young thing. You get me? To be real, certain young fans, they talk to man. That's fans, innit? They're cool. I show them respect because they like my music. They shout, man. It's cool. Man's not moving to them or do any intercourse, sexual intercourse with them. You get me? Man don't do that. Man don't do that, bro. You get me? Man's never... I'm not raised up to be fucking young things, my brother. You feel me? That young thing joke, is that a fucking joke, my brother? Who the fuck have I fucked, man? Girls lie about their age all the time. That's why girls are trash, you feel me? Girls are trash. They're trash, brother. Like, you can't say to me that I fucked a young thing, but you can't back it up. You ever fucked? I haven't fucked no one. And this is the excuse, because you talk to her. What? I'm talking to a female fan. I'm not going to tell my fan to fuck off, fam. You know that? Would you do that, brother?
Nah. Exactly. But what we want to ask you is, why did you come up on Insta Live and ask a girl if she thinks you are? Like, all the time, you know yourself as a man. You don't need no one else to tell you what you are. Why did you do that?
Brother, well, I know that I'm not in it. It's good that you mentioned that question, brother. I really wanted to answer this question from the public here, this, innit? But at the end of the day, my brother, cool, the girl's been in my life, innit? But I just want to ask her, because this bear man just talking about pedo shit. It's come up on the conversation in the lab. So I'm asking her, it's good to know, because I want to know what a female thinks, bruv. You get me? Now, I want to know what a female thinks, because most of these females wouldn't talk to me if I'm a fucking pedophile, fam. Does that make fucking sense, guys? How does that make sense? A chick wouldn't talk to me, fam. Listen, a girl wouldn't talk to me, my buddy, yeah? Listen, a girl wouldn't talk to me if I'm a pedophile, innit? How does that make sense? You feel me? Girls come to me. Girls come on the road and show me love, but the reason why I had to just ask her, fam, you get me? Do you think, I just want to see whether the girl's real. Mama's testing the fucking bitch, fam. You know like that? Man's testing the bitch. She's a fake bitch, innit? Forget her, innit? But man just asking the bitch. I can't even call her a girl, man. She's a bitch. Man can't even trust that bitch, yeah? Like, I'm asking her, do you think I'm a pedo? It's just a normal question. I just want to know her outcome of the situation. You get me? So yes. I just want to know her opinion, brother. What she thinks, you get me? But she's moving mad. I don't understand, but she never ever said that she thinks I'm a pedo. Because if I'm a pedo, why are you still alive with me? But she never said that, innit? That's the good thing. She never ever said that because she knows man's not a pedo. I asked her for her age. She said she's over age. If you lied, then fuck you, fam. Then you're dickhead. But I don't think she did because she is over age. A couple people have told me that. Well, cool. But the girls are bad as innit. Fuck that bitch, innit? But at the end of the day, my brother, I'm just asking a normal question. I just want to know their opinion.
Yeah.
Because of what's been said. I want to know if a girl thinks that I'm a pedo. You feel me? I'm just asking. It's a simple question, fam. So that's what I'm saying, brother. Because all these people that chat shit on Insta, they're going to make it look like it's something bad. I'm just asking a girl a fucking simple question, my brother. You feel me?
Yeah.
I'm
asking her. What he's saying is you asking her that makes people think that you're indecisive in yourself. Like, you don't know what you are. Because if you do, you don't have to ask no one nothing.
I understand that, my brother. I understand that. But it was just a simple question. You see the way you looked at it? I never looked at it like that. You get me? That's you, fam. That's what you think. You get me, fam? That's what you think. And that's wrong, bro. It's what you're thinking. If you're thinking, looking at it like that, then, brother, that's mad, fam.
Yeah.
Fam, come on, fam. If you're looking at it like that yourself, well, allow that, fam. You get me? Because man ain't like that, fam. You fool me? Like, man's a bro fucking G, fam. Like, man, don't fuck no young things. I'm just asking a simple question. I never looked at it like that. I'm just looking at it as a simple question.
Yeah.
But when I sat back and kind of watched that live, Because obviously, yeah, I just see it and that, right? Sometimes it pops up on my thing as well, you get me? But yeah. When I've looked at it, bro, man's looked at it from and seen certain things, but obviously, I don't see, I've never seen when I've looked at the lab and seen my spider bite. I'm asking you a normal question. Yeah. You get me? Of course, the bitch is going to chat shit. She's a fucking J-bag anyway, man. She's on every single person's lab, bro. And she's got kids and that. She's on lab with me when her kids are screaming in the fucking background, because saying feed man and that from a fool, like I'm joking and shit. Like, the girl's down at it, but obviously it's cool. But at the end of the day, bro, it's good that she never said that, bro. You get me?
Yeah.
I just asked the girl a normal question, but that's what I asked her. Do you think I'm a pedo? So I don't see how that's wrong. I just want to know what other females think about it, but it's just a question where I want to know what other females are saying about the situation. You feel me?
Yeah.
That's what I want to know, fam. I just wanted to know what's their opinion, because I don't want no fake people around me. There's a lot of fake people, innit? That most people know it's not true. Just because the media said that, some people could think it's true. But if you think it's true, speak to man, fam. If you're a fake person, fuck off from my life, fam. Like, you get me? Don't come around me, fam. You think I've got time for fake niggas? I'm trying to have more bands than fucking friends anyways, fam. You get me? Niggas are fake. You get me? I've got love for my real guys, love to my 061s and that. Nah, that's it, fam. But other niggas, they're fake anyway, brother. You get me?
Okay. But let's get on to something else under that situation. People are saying that Kid Aveli has got young girls following him, or he's following them. Is Kid Aveli following anybody who's under the age of 18?
Bro, I've got big women in my things. Cool. All these people that said that I'm following young girls, brother, they're fans. If they're fans, they're fans. It's not my fucking fault, bro. It's my fault. If you like my music, am I gonna tell you to fuck off, my brother? Listen, I cool. For example, G, if you was a rapper and you had young girls, obviously, that add you and whatever, and that they support your thing and tagging your story and they're fans, you're not fucking them or going out on a date or going on fucking chicken wings and fries dates and that, my bro. Would you reject them?
Nah. But what I'm saying to you, yeah, anybody can follow you. No one can't diss you for that.
Exactly.
But are you following back anybody who's under the age of 18?
Bro, you can't tell whether the age of that, but most girls nowadays look older, brother.
Yeah.
Most girls look older. You get me? I'm with the girls on the roads, bro, they look like they're 20 fucking 4 or 23, bro, brother. 23 to 25, and then they tell me the age, that this age, bam, I walk off. I just give them probably my mixtape, just support my mixtape. I give them the link to my mixtape. If they're fans, there's a difference, brother, between fans and moving to someone, innit?
Bro, yeah.
I respect the female fans, whether you're young or not, brother, I respect that. Because I'm not moving to you. We're not going out on dates, I'm not fucking you or nothing. If you love my music and just supporting me, whether you're young, why am I going to tell you to fuck off? You're coming on a road talking to me, you feel me?
Yeah.
So why am I going to tell you to fuck off, brother, you get me? If you follow me, cool. I don't know your age, bro. I'm not fucking, what's his name in that? What's my man? Professor, whatever his name is in that, from fucking X-Men, brother. I'm not the professor from X-Men, brother, to read people's minds, man, again, you feel me? But I wish I was like that, can read people's minds, that would be good, but at the end of the day, bro, how am I meant to know?
Yeah.
You get me? Girls lie about their age all the time, brother, you feel me? This is what girls do. Girls lie about their age, innit? But at the end of the day, bro, it's cool. Because at the end of the day, my nigga, that it's fans, that young girls that talk to me. I've never ever done roof to any young thing. I always ask every girl that talks to me, I always ask them about their age. If they're fans, I'm happy, fam. Support the thing. They're supporters, fam. I want them to see me win as well. They want to see me win. They believe in me. Yeah. Most girls that talk to me, brother, they're old enough. I've got older girls. Certain girls have come in my life that are going live with people saying they're young things. When they say they're real age and back up passports, what can man really say then? You got a set of girls that's 30 or older than me, G, by like 5-6 years. Like 5 years, 30 on my life. And you got a set of other girls that's that, what? That 20, whatever and that. And some that's that 19. You're over 18. You're 18 plus, that's cool, you get me? But I've got bare girls I know that's older than me. My baby mom's older than me, so how can I be a pedo? If I was a pedo, I'm 25, but I turned 25 this year in February, my brother, yeah? If I was a pedo, then my baby mum would have been fucking, what, 16? If I was a pedophile. But it's not, because she's fucking 28 years old, man.
Yeah.
So suck yourself. If everyone that's chatting shit, G, they can fuck themselves, because if you're bringing up pedo shit when that's not even come in my mind, you're done at it. They don't know the difference between having fans, talking to, whether they're young, yeah, they could be young, I've got older fans and young fans, innit, bro? It's not my fault. If they like, man, I'm not gonna tell them to fuck off. I'm a real fucking nigga, fam. You like my shit, support the thing. I'm not moving to you. There's a difference between fans and moving to a girl. But these niggas, because they're so fucking retarded, and they're fucking chickens, and they got a fucking duck brain and that, a duck's fucking brain, they don't know what's going on. Make your rumors, but whatever. I promise you, fam. Trust you, fam. Man's still winning, so fuck you, innit? How about that? You hear me?
Okay, so on that situation, last question. Have you ever said the words out of your mouth that you like young girls?
Bro, oh my mum's life, brother. Listen, bro.
I'll stand up and say it, bro. Like, listen, the Lord himself is watching, innit?
The Lord himself is watching, my brother. And whatever, the Lord, the devil, whatever, brother, is watching the thing, brother. You feel me? At the end of the day, my brother, I've never said that. You see what went on YouTube is good, but I wanted to say this from time, and this is the perfect time for me to say it. This guy's so stupid, yeah? Cool. That brother that uploaded the page, yeah? Bro, the Donnie has said, brother, that I'm talking about, if you're 16 or under, bring it to my video. Do you know what he's done? He's blurred up the fucking video, bro. He's blurred it up because he's an internet geek. He's a geek. He probably's got fucking blonde hair and got blue eyes. Called fucking Charlie and that, but that lives in a fucking country home, sad, and that's gassed over the thing. Get me, but yeah, this thing, but it's cut that in it, but yeah, seeing that, but obviously, yeah, but I crept still, but obviously, fam, it's just a blue eyes nigga. Fam, you think I got time to take in a man like that serious? You're saying to me, bring 60, but the full video, yeah? Let me tell you how this shoot is stupid, yeah? He's put up the full video on his page. If he deletes this, he's a fucking nerd. Because everyone's seen it. It will save this kid of Eddie talking to a fat wobble. He said, kid of Eddie talking to a fat wobble. That's what he said on YouTube, yeah? On his page. That fucking faggot you, yeah? He said, it will save this kid of Eddie talking to a fat wobble. But I literally said, brother, if the girl, brother, is that fam, I told him, if the girl's 16 or under, don't bring them to my video. Don't. D-O-N-T. Don't bring them to my video. Don't bring them to my video. D-O-N-T. Don't. I said, don't bring them to my video. But what the pussy has done, because he's trying to just act for subscribers, he's trying to make me look like a pedo. And he makes fake accounts. He's on a hell of fake accounts. Brother, this guy's a fucking internet guy. You fool me? That's out there trying to chase the subscribers, but you don't get in nowhere, you fucking faggot. What happened when I fucking, when you tried to leak my video? You leaked my video, and I got your shit copyrighted, fam. My manager copied, fam, we copyrighted your shit, fam. Me and him, you fucking faggot. What happened? You're on your last warning, bro. You've got another strike, one or two more strikes, and your channel's done. You fucking faggot, fam. You learnt your lesson. Don't ever try to do that, because I can shut down the whole channel, you fucking faggot, you fool me? But at the end of the day, my nigga, that all of that is fake. It's fake, bro, because he's blurred out the thing, and it could make man look like a pedo, because he's blurred it out. Certain people that are stupid are gonna obviously fall for that fucking trick. You get me? They're gonna fall for the fucking trick, but lie that, man. Lie that, fam, man's not no pedo. I know what I said, because the full video was from Save This Kid of Early talking to a fat wobble. I said if the girl's under 16 or whatever, 16 and under, don't bring them to my video. But he's trying to like blur out the bit where I said don't like bring them to my video. So it sounds like that, oh, bring them to my video. How leaky is that, brother? Is that leaky, my boy?
Yeah.
Everyone's seen the video. The yeah, video was bad. You see the video with a fat wobble or whatever, she was calm, she was a supporter. She lives off ends, fam. She was from like Sheffield. She's cool. She come on my lab on a routine. I respect that. She was overage. You get me? It's cool. She went no young thing or nothing. But it's just the haters, because they see me getting girls that they can't get. How about that? Because you're a fucking virgin and you're not fucking a pussy and pushing back your foreskin. Don't hate, brother. You sit in your fucking house all day and make shit and make lies about Kid Avelli. Suck your mum, fam.
Love, fam.
You get me? Okay. I've said, my brother, I have to see the truth in that, because it's really shit, my brother. It's good that he said that, my brother. That has to be said. I love that, my brother. I like you still. I like that, my brother, because that had to be said, my G. You're all niggas still. I wanted to always explain that, but it's better to explain it on an interview like this, you fool me?
Yeah.
It's better to explain that, fam. Come on, fam.
Okay, let's get on to something else now. One time you put up an Insta post where you blatantly got the Rambo in your hand. We've all seen it. The big knife was swinging left to right. So right about now, from that post, somebody has made shirts. I'd say sweatshirts with your face on it, holding the knife. And for all we know, they're looking to sell those shirts. Now, do you think that's a good advertisement to be spread out there? And what do you feel about the fact that someone's done that over one of your posts?
To be honest with you, bro, I'll be real with you, man. You see, like, whatever that happened, brother, like, people are forward doing it. As I've said to you, the UK journalist guy, he's an internet beast, innit? He's an internet beast, he knows what he's doing. He's a faggot, but he knows what he's doing, innit? You get me? He knows what he's doing, but like, it's fake, innit? You think you can make money off me when I've got serious links? You're not making no money off me, because that money you're making is going to come to me, you fucking faggot. If you make money before me, I'll get that back. I'll make more than you back, you fucking idiot. You get me? There's worse things about it. Cool, let's get down to the serious part. The funniest thing about it, they're not even shirts, man. They're editing. They're editing shirts, bro. What he's done, he's gone into a website. Cool. I know what he's done, but he's gone into a website. Obviously, he knows what he's doing. He's an internet beast. He's probably a guy with fucking, I don't know if I'm that. You get me? Blonde hair or something, and like, sitting on the screen, and I like, called fucking Charlie or something. Charlie? You get me? Like, he's out there. Oh, fam. Bro, he's gone onto a next fucking, like, let's say a website, yeah? That sells shirts and that, buddy, yeah? He's gone onto there, brother, and edited the next shirt, and he's put an 061 logo saying UK Jewel Knowledge. Who the fuck's gonna buy that, fam? Right? Come on, fam. Who's gonna buy that? You think people are supporting this guy? The guy's a, like, come on, who's supporting him?
But just for the fact he's clearly putting that out there.
He's clearly doing it. He's clearly doing it for the views and subscribers for his channel. I understand he's a hungry nigga probably trying to make bread, but fuck that, bro. They're not making no bread off me if I'm not eating a carb. You think you can sell my shit without me making, with my name in it, without me getting a cut off it? Fuck off. It's all edited, my brother. He's just gone on a normal website with shirts because he knows what he's doing and just printed the 061 thing on it. It's an edited thing. It's edited, bro. So no one's making no money off it. Where's the website? Cool. He's talking about website. You can't see the website. You can't even show the fucking website. You fucking idiot, fam. Like, you get me? Like, come on, fam. Like, this guy, fam, he's been doing the most, but it's like he's been trying to put me in jail. He said feds coming to my yard numerous amount of times. You get me? If I ever knew who this shit was, if I ever knew his face, my brother, I'm telling you, fam, I'd hurt this guy differently, fam. Differently, brother. Now, he thinks he can make money off me, and I don't get money off it. Come on, brother, fam. He's gonna, all right, brother, he's done that, yeah, man.
Okay, let's cut off from my man over there.
Yeah,
let's get on to the fact that, like we're saying, you've got bare footages on YouTube.
Mm.
Bare footages. Yeah, most of them ain't even under you, they're under other people. A lot of people have actually mocked videos that you've done, and they've added bits, they've made bits look wrong,
exactly. They've
fucked with the footages. How do you feel about all the mocked footages that are going to be on YouTube now for the rest of your life, maybe?
To be honest with you, bro, it's mad, isn't it? Looking at it, my bro, it's a mad thing, isn't it? Because you got bare man putting shit on my names, but in a way, it's helped out. It's part of the game, isn't it? They love man. They love man at the end of the day, my brother. But certain things that's gone up there should even be up there, fam. You get me? With certain things that's cool, it happens, isn't it? It's part of the game, my brother. But obviously, certain man putting up certain content has nearly put me back in jail, innit? I don't like that, innit? There's certain things that I don't like. There's certain things that's come, and certain things that I don't like. Because I'm an artist, you feel me? But these niggas trying to tarnish my name by putting certain things on my name, cool, you click on the video. It's not like that. I can't rate, man. At least save the video correctly, you fucking faggots, fam. You feel me, fucking faggot, fam? save the video correctly, innit? Then you come out here and talk to me. Can't say it to my face, come out these streets and say that to my fam. You save a video as something else, you click on it, every time I clicked on it, it's different. You get me? There's only about 2-3 people on there that really respect my that London Joe Media, you don't draw me out. Ruger Santana channel don't draw me out. And I can't even remember the other one, but like 3 of them, they actually picks me up by the other ones. What they do is they'll save it as certain, innit? I know how the game goes, cool, fair enough. I know what the game they're playing, but you don't need to do that, fam. Don't try to tarnish man's name, fam. Because I ain't the one, fam. I'll box your fucking face, fam. You get boxed in your fucking face, you feel me? If I saw you right now, I'm gonna box your face, fam. Don't ever try that, you feel me? Whether it's camera or not, I'll show, man, because the same energy I have, come on, fam. I left niggas screaming like fucking chickens and that, or fucking, on fucking stole my story. Don't chat shit, fam. Come on, fam. I need. Come on, fam. Mm.
Okay, let's get back into the vault. That is what we're telling you. All that vault stuff's long. We don't want to see you on a madness with anyone or anyone on a madness with you. But what people are saying is so far, a lot of the things you put up is, yeah, you're onto people. Mm. Nobody ain't onto you. But what they're saying is Kid Afeli really ready for when one of those dirty road men that is on something sees it and they're ready to do this thing.
That's what I'm saying, what dirty road men, bro?
Someone who's really about that life like you say you are.
Bro, they see me, I say I'm about this life, I speak from confidence because I back my chat, so niggas can never say I'm a verbalist, innit? Whether a man, I might look at like a verbalist cool to other people, but bro, but people I've seen in the field, I do my thing. I'm far from a verbalist, you feel me? I'm far from a verbalist, you feel me? Because, no, like, I've seen certain people and they ain't done shit to me. It's been them getting G-checked. How about that, you feel me? Like, man, I'm a C-man out here. Like, if I'm a C-man out here, it's cool, it is what it is, you feel me? Man's focused on bigger things. Man's got money and music, I'm focused on doing big things right now, but if it is, if I see man, brother, come on, brother. You know what it is, man. All this shit you see on YouTube, me really out there doing, putting in work, that is cool from day one. Certain videos I've got shut down from YouTube, me showing my burner from last year. The video got shut down from YouTube, putting slugs and sweets that showing my burner on live, and people chat shit. When I don't show up enough and I put it in a plastic bag, whatever, people chat shit and say it's this and that. But fuck them, innit? I ain't trying to beat myself up because I know I'm going to be beat. But obviously, bro, I don't understand, fam, because not know most people, they say, I was onto man see them, whoever have had beef, we've seen them, and it's been a different story. Some people, I ain't seen them, because I mean, if we see each other, then it's a different story, you feel me? If I see you, man's going to do you in, but that's how it goes, you feel me? Regardless, I'm focused, but if I do see you, it's on, you feel me? But other people, that's just chatting bare shit, bro, fuck them, innit, fam, you get me? Because people are getting too gassed in the media over Kid Afeli's name, but I'm getting love in their own ends. Fucking faggots, but obviously, bro, no real niggas. I'm not saying that I'm the hardest out. I don't talk like I'm Superman. Anyone can get touched. But I speak from things that I've seen and lived and that I've seen with my own eyes, you feel me? So, the real niggas though, fam, from when I was Kid Kane and now I'm Kid Afeli, cool. You get me, fam, it's a different thing, fam. You get me that? When it's focused, but fuck with me, bro, it'll always be the fucking same, bro. You get me? So, no real niggas have come to me and showed me how I'm fucking went. Where are they? They're all fools. Enough said, bro.
Okay, well, let's get on to the moment.
I haven't been stabbed, my brother. Can you see any scars on me right now, but even from my hands, my brother? Come on, I haven't been stabbed. This is not even a stab, my brother. This is just a cut, fam.
Yeah.
You get me, fam? It's just a lap work and I'm being stabbed on that in my brother. This is a cut from like, look, it's even healing. Does this look like a stab mark? Bro, this is just from the other day, my brother. It's that one, man. I even showed it on live about like a week or two ago. You get me? So that people can't talk, man.
Okay, let's get on to one of the most important things of this interview. Mum. Mum is the world, you get me? Without mum, there's no Kid Afeli. Now, a lot of people are upset because they saw a post up there where Kid Aveli looked like he don't respect mum and what she is to him.
I hear that. He was
on some shit that night. It was like he was telling mum that she needs to come out. She needs to know what time it is. People are saying, listen, don't ever disrespect your mum, especially for other people to get a view or a like. What does Kid Aveli say about that?
Bro, I'll be real with man, fam. You see all that shit, yeah? Man, see on that live, that was a mad thing. I don't even know how man was on Insta live, but you get me? That shit has got paused because people were meant to see that. But at the end of the day, that's man's march, you get me? It's that way. Everyone has arguments with their man, bro. Yeah. You get me? Whatever you see is there. I'm not gonna type. You get me? It's not for Insta live, G, because at the end of the day, I remember pausing that. Like, look at my phone, my brother. I can press this, yeah?
Yeah.
Look, that right now, what is, I press this button, cool, it's paused. You feel me? It's gone back to black. But at the end of the day, what I'm saying is, well, I paused the thing, don't know how people see it, innit? But at the end of the day, my brother, man's got respect for my march, you feel me?
Yeah.
That's it, you get me? Man offers my march things and that, you feel me? I offer things and try to help her out, but you get me? That's how it goes, brother. You get me? Man helps out my march as well, brother, you get me? So man can't tell me nothing because everyone has arguments. That day was the bad day for me, innit? It wasn't the right day for me. Everyone has arguments, bro. Me, I've got a mad temper because man, it'll flip out quick over certain things. It's cool. Whatever happened, that's still my march, man. That's my blood. She carried me for fucking 9 months on this fucking earth, bro. You know what I'm saying? Come on, fam. That fucking questions, fam, man. You get me?
Yeah.
That fuck all of that.
So do you, Kid Aveli, fully understand that mum is the world and nothing comes before her?
Obviously, it does. Obviously, yeah, that's your margin, innit? I'm just saying, not nothing like that, but that's my margin, innit?
Yeah.
That's my mom. She gave birth to me. I respect that. That's what a man's saying, innit?
Yeah.
I respect that. She gave birth to me. I respect that. Whatever happened in that Insta lab, my brother, was mad, innit? That was a bit mad. That was a meant to go thing. That's meant to be a mother and son conversation.
Yeah.
But, you fool me, fam.
How did it go live?
Well, because mum was on live at that time, I can't remember, I think I was having an argument in front of my ops, you feel me?
Yeah.
Just going back and forth, it's cool, but I've got my own yard, innit? Man's got a yard, man can stay at. I've got a yard, man can stay at. But that day, when I've been staying at a yard for some time, I go check up on it. Just because of where my dress got leaked, you feel me?
Yeah.
People hacked my dress, so man's got like, where people hack my dress, man has to go and check up on my margin, fam, see if she's fucking good, fam.
Yeah.
Is there anyone that ever comes to my mom's house, you're a dead man. You're dead, fam. You're hangman. You're gonna be playing hangman, fam. I'm gonna be playing the hangman with you. You feel me? Mm. They never step foot in my fucking mom's house, son. You get me? But at the end of the day, bro, I got love for that. That's what Margie, fam. She carried me for 9 months. Like, everyone has arguments with their mom. Whenever you ever argue with your mom, you still got love for her, bro. I still help her out when I can, you feel me?
Yeah.
Like, when I can, man will help her out, but you feel me? I do that. I help her as well. You get me? Same way she felt, man, when I was young. But it's cool, fam. We ain't ever been on good terms. See me and my march, we ain't been on good terms like that, you feel me?
Yeah.
But I still have respect, you feel me? Okay. We've never got along, but we've always been, like, I still show her respect, you feel me? But they carried me for 9 months on this earth, bro. You feel me? Like, come on, brother. Like, if mum wasn't here, it would be peak, you feel me? If I wasn't born, mum won't be kidding, baby. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, but at the end of the day, fam, man, respect that, innit? But whatever happened, my brother, that's an argument. Everyone has argument with their margie. But I remember I paused it. I don't know how it ended up on Instagram, but I was shocked when I took out my phone. But the phone went black, like I'll show you that right now. Let's say I'm on live right now. You can see, let's say man's on fucking live. And man turns on the phone, cool. That's gone, look. And of course, it's black. It's paused. You feel me? You can't see shit because I paused the thing. The screen's gone blank. You feel me? So I don't understand how the fuck my phone came on by itself, but when that was meant to be a mother and son conversation. So, come on, man, like, you get me? But shit happened, it's gone out there, bro. It might look mad, it happened, innit? My marge knows what I'm like, you get me? She knows what I'm involved in. My marge is not stupid, fam, you get me? But whatever happened, my brother still got love for her, innit? She still got love for me. Shit happened, my brother, you feel me? That's it, my brother, you get me, fam.
Okay.
I'll never let anything happen to my margie or leave my mom out here like that, fam.
Yeah.
That's my, like, come on, that's my blood, man. She gave me fucking thingy. Whether you, man, don't get along or don't like each other or whatever, she still brought me to this earth. Whatever you thought about her, whatever, she still brought me to this fucking earth, fam. You get me? Come on, bro.
Okay, let's get on to one of the reasons why people are saying that they don't think Chiavelli's all there. You done a post up there where you were saying that you want to see an apocalypse. And you're talking about you want to see everyone turn into zombies. Was that a joke thing or what was going on?
To be honest, fuck most people in it, fam. I wish that the links that I've got, the people I know, the people I've got respect for, love for them, innit? I've got respect for them, my brother, but for people that's really tried to say certain things, for other people that's trying to bring me down, and other people that swipe or blah, 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 I wish they'd turn into zombies. Fuck the minute I said that, because it's just that media. I just thought that nobody, if I'm trying to have more bands than friends, I've got real, me, I look after my people, innit? I've looked after real people that's had money, for me, bro. Real people that's had, that not even had money, what am I talking about? That I've had them. I've looked after people, I've had them, bro, and they've turned into fucking Judas. The man have turned into Judas, bro, so fuck them, you feel me? So fuck them. That's why I cut off bare, man. I'm a lone wolf now, my buddy, you feel me? I do my own thing, free my niggas in the jail, free cash, free skits, Tia, Biggs, Little Chucks. Fam, many more to speak, my brother. The people that's with me in the roads now, laughed in a minute, fam, but the rest of the niggas, brother, they're not with, man. They're just trying to be around me because of clout, innit? I've looked after a lot of people, my nigga. And they've turned snakes and they're trying to come back to me. They deserve to turn into zombies because they're fucking fake. I've known it for fake, innit? But I've been surrounded by fake niggas. Started apocalypse on them niggas. I don't give a fuck if they die today. It's not my business. What the fuck am I going to care about? Was he there for my life? Cool. You made certain man sleep in my baby mum's house. You hear me? Certain man slept in my baby mum's house, bro. And she was my girl at that time. I went out with her for 2.5 years, bro. I never let anyone stay in my fucking girl's house. Cool, you stayed in my girl's house, you fucking faggots. Who bought you Domino's there? Fucking idiots. Who sent you OT? You fucking faggots. You hear me? Fuck them. All the men were fake. I clocked a lot of men are fake, but you see me? Sometimes you just keep it cool, innit? And think, right, I might be over-exaggerating when you know that they're fake. You fool me? So their man deserve to start a zombie, but it's what man's been through. Set a man... They can turn into an apocalypse. Keep the real niggas don't deserve to turn into apocalypse, man. The rest of them, fuck them all, cuz they're not doing nothing, man. Fuck them all, cuz turn into zombies, you fucking faggots.
Okay, let's get on to another post you put up there that angered a lot of people. You said that you don't give a fuck about anyone that prays. You said praying is for retards. That's what the words were. Praying is for retards. Now, there's people that pray 5 times a day and believe in the Muslim and Quran way of life. They're upset with that. Like, where do you get off? Who are you to say that about people that pray?
It's fair enough, innit? But to other people that pray, fam, this is, I'm just saying my message, my buddy. For me, that's my message. But other people that pray, cousin, that. To what I've done, brother, I've always been a holy man, you feel me?
Yeah.
I grew up as a Catholic, man, you know? Come out of jail, I got reborn again, you feel me? Man was reborn again, fam, you feel me? Man got reborn again when I come out of jail. I was a reborn again Christian, now, brother. My dad was a Christian, my mum was a Catholic, innit?
Yeah.
In school. But when I came out of jail, bro, I prayed for years, brother. Like, me, I just lost hope in religions, bro. Love the God himself, innit? It's not that man's disrespecting him, brother. But at the end of the day, I don't care, fam. At the end of the day, fuck it, fam. At the end of the day, like, when I've prayed, nothing's happened to me. I prayed to God and nothing's ever happened to my life. Or I see one progress happen to me. Cool. I've gone jail about 5 times.
Have I seen anything happen to my life? Nothing. Brother, God help me put fucking bust case, fam. Nothing happened, but still love the God, innit? It's how you think, you get me?
Yeah.
It's how you think. But at the end of the day, I ain't seen fuck all happen, bro. You get me? That's what made me lose fucking focus on religions. If I pray, I want to see something fucking happen now, fam. You get me? If I'm not seeing something happen now, what the fuck am I here for, fam? You get me? I've prayed in that, brother. You get me? I've prayed in that, man. Believed in God, but I was always a holy man. Regardless, whether I've splashed niggas, done this, whatever, done bun niggas, well, bun niggas, shot niggas, whatever, but I splashed niggas, it's that work. The real niggas know, it's cool, I'm not gonna talk no more bait, my brother, no bait talk, but I don't wanna answer certain questions, but at the end of the day, but I don't have to answer that question, innit?
I believed in what I believed in, but I just didn't see the certain way. Imagine everyone thinks I'm by judge, but I don't by judge.
Yeah. But what we're saying is that's fair enough what you're saying for you. Because if you never saw a message from your prayer, then you can believe on your side what you believe.
I believe in it because I believe in it.
But who are you to say that anybody who prays is a lunatic?
Well, I'm just saying that from that, obviously, because of what I've seen, of what I've fucking seen, I ain't seen any of them that's prayed anything happen to them. So I'm judging from what I've seen to me, cool. I've prayed for time. I'm not saying, blah, blah, fuck God or whatever, but it is what it is, isn't it, fam? I don't care, fam. I'm saying what I'm fucking saying, innit? I don't care, fam. Man's prayed, but I ain't seen that. I haven't seen nothing happen to me, innit? I've gone jail bad times. I've just lost hope in it. I believe in me. You feel me? I still pray to God sometimes. Don't get it twisted. It's a bit weird. It might look a bit weird. You might still pray to God there and there, but at the end of the day, my brother, me, like with that, brother, every time man prays, brother, do you know what made me actually lose? Let me tell you now, fuck it, man. I didn't want to say this on camera, but what made me lose hope, my brother, yeah? Is that every time I prayed, my life got worse, man. You get me? I've seen it, fam. I never seen nothing happen good in my life when I fucking prayed, fam. You feel me? But at the end of the day, that's what man just saying, innit? That's what I'm saying, you feel me? To other people out there that's praying, you can believe in God. I'm not telling you just because I don't believe in God. I'm not saying that don't believe in God. You feel me? Do your fucking thing, fam. You get me? But I'm speaking of the experience that I've done. That, like, oh, trust me, fam. Man, I used to go to church with my grandma and shit as well. You get me? When I was younger. You get me? I used to do this thing. You feel me? Whether mom was an old man doing things, man sometimes will go to church. But I'm not praying for my pagans, fam. I'm not regretful for anything that I've done to my pagans. How about that? You feel me? My pagans deserve what's happened to them. Fucking faggots. Get me, fucking faggots. You deserve what's happened to you because you tried to do the same thing to me. Cool, but I'm not getting touched. But you've tried and failed. But when we do it, we pass our mission. We accomplish our mission. But at the end of the day, why should I pray for my fucking pagans, bro? You think I'm going to church to pray for my fucking pagan? I'm half thinking. But I believe that I'll pray to God himself for me and to help my family and shit like that. And my fucking kids and my bro niggas. Not no fake niggas, you get me? I'd rather pray to God to help my family. I'd rather want God to help my family, my kid. Like me, help me first. Help my family and help my kids. And help my fucking, and help my bro niggas. Not fake niggas, innit? Help us. But I haven't seen nothing like that happen, my brother, innit? But I'm not telling everyone out there, they might see it different, innit? Certain people might see it different, bro, but I'm not telling you to not believe in your God. If you believe in God, brother, believe in it. If shit's working out for you and you believe in God, believe in that, bro. That's you, fam. But me, I've got my own opinion. That's me. You feel me? From what I've seen, if it works out good for you, good luck, brother. Respect that, fam. Believe in your religion. You believe in something, that's good. If you don't believe in yourself and you believe in God the most, then do your thing.
Okay. Yeah. Let's get over to the Insta Live beefs. You got Russ, you got African Child, you got World Boss. We've all seen you have words with all of them. What we want to know, is it all just talk? Bare locations, bare less link up, bare this one's pussy, that one's pussy. Is there really any beef with any of them?
To be honest with you, let me explain to you about call one. Two of them, they're patties, innit? Number two, bro, I've seen World Boss before. And Barra, fam. He's in Tabwa, remember, in my hood. Brother, don't even look like he wanted to go through the red lights, my brother. I've said this already, we've gone on live. Donnie was nervous out of his life, my nigga. I'm looking at you right now. That's like me looking at you, how the energy you've got on Instagram. You ain't got that in real life, my nigga. I was there with one of my niggas I've added to the live. When I fucking went live with this patty, my nigga said the same thing. I was talking to him when we see him. I said, I swear this guy looks familiar. I didn't even know World Boss. I thought, on the other hand, I never knew World Boss. You get me? World Boss, I knew him through one guy on Insta. He was cool and that. It was like a UK Joe News. You had like 100k followers. Then you had 200k. Called UK Court Slipping. UK Court Slipping brought him to my life. I don't know the... I never even heard of him, bro. Bro, would you have heard of World Boss or AC before this Insta thing?
Nah.
Exactly, brother. I didn't know, man. He's come on to me and I talked to him and I said certain things to him in inbox after, you're cool. But my man's a patty. I told him, bruv, you're a joke, man. I'm not even cool with you, fam. You know that? When he tried to sleep this week, man's told him about himself. You get me? Because when I saw you in Barra, that time was cool when I saw him in Barra, yeah? And Tabard. Next to Tabard Street, bro. Where the other faggot got chased out, where all the faggots had madness. It's a Barra station, where they got. I've seen him. But I'm looking at him in the traffic, when the Donnie's at this. He's looking at man, and he's like, fam, he can't wait for the fucking green light to go past, man. Donnie was scared out of his shit. I can put that down on anything, my brother. Anything. Guy's a faggot. Obviously, he's a comedian. He's got comedy in his name. Why am I meant to take my someone like that serious? I'm there, coming. I just want to chat. I would have probably came and spotted him. I'm looking at him. He's moving nervous. Cool. He's gone. School G, he's still going through the lights, bro. He was cool. He's even gone early. Before the things even turn orange when you have to start. You know, like that. Getting ready to go past the lights. And when it's green and you go past, my man's a dickhead, fam. He's finished. But obviously, fuck him. He's a nerd. AC, bro. Donnie is a big man. You're a big man, my brother. Like, you're out there acting for views, brother. You're not going to blow for shit, fam. You're not going to blow. You're not even my up. All these men, you mentioned my name when I didn't even know you exist in this world, my brother. Niggas were sending me lives of you. You get me? When people sent me lives of you, that's when I knew that you probably exist in this world, my nigga. You were, and I started seeing videos of you sending for Fredo, Asco, for me, Asco, Fredo, Heady One, and all these, my brother. You're a joke, man. You're a joke. Like, he's a joke, my brother. This guy is a granddad now, my brother. He's talking about, he still thinks he's living in the 1990s, the 80s. That's the last time he's putting white. AC's a fool, but I've gave him enough. I've gave him a postcode numerous amount of times. I've gone on live twice. Gave him a postcode. Come and butt me, my brother. It's not hard. SE1, 1YQ, Tabard Street, my brother. Or Long Lane. Come and butt me. Where has he come? He hasn't come nowhere, my brother. But he acts for the snap. You got, how can I take a man serious that has his account on private, my nigga? You got your account on private. And you think you can chat shit to me? You're not even my op. I can never ever class you as my op. You're just someone that I see, that when I see them, I'll just do something to you. You're not my op, fam. You get me? You're a dickhead. Stop begging beef. No known artist have replied back to you, apart from me and Buck Fiddy. And Buck Fiddy, me and Buck Fiddy exposed you. Like, we made you look like shit. You can't have chat for me, bro, and anything in life. AC, my brother, have chat for anybody in life. Brother, you're claiming benefits. Your girl used to look after you, man. They go, your girl's a J-bag. I've been in the car with someone that you know, I'm not going to say their names for certain purposes, my brother, yeah? I respect them, innit? They told me, kid, please don't mention my name for any Instagram live, interviews, whatever you do. Cool. I respect that, Donnie. But, fam, I've been around that nigga so many times, brother. He's called you off his phone. Brother, telling you about Kid Avelli, you wasn't had that same energy. That's why you don't have the same energy for me that you have for Neeks. Donnie only has energies for Neeks, my brother. Don't you agree that, brother? Who is he with, my brother? Who the fuck is he touched? Cool. You've been a gangster, you say this, you drop bodies. You ain't dropped no bodies. No one can claim you drop bodies. Not on Insta Live. I'm not going to make them confess on Insta Live about dropping bodies. Am I a dickhead? I ain't trying to get you back. You're a Neek. But bro, at the end of the day, my mama, brother, it's just a Neek, brother. No one's confirmed. The guy was with him said he hasn't even dropped bodies. He don't drop bodies, bro. He's saying he wants to do it for internet views. Fucking idiot said he's fighting World Boss. When it happened, I said I'll fight him. Fuck World Boss. He's scared of man. He don't give me that same energy because he knows what man's on. In his heart, he knows that. I can see it all over his fucking eyes that he's doing it for Insta. His own guy badded him up about he used to fucking... His own guy badded him up about he used to put petrol in his car that he fucked his baby mum. What was his name? The guy was called Kim. The Kim guy that's on YouTube badded him up, bro. Like, this guy's not my up, man. He's just begging it off all these people. But who's he touched, bro? Have you seen him ever go to any of these up blocks that he's talking about, bro? No one. He hasn't talked about no single person, brother. No single person. Like, brother, you talk about all these people, but he hasn't gone and done one role. What has he done? If you're really on it, he's got energy for civilians, my brother. You're G-checking civilians. Civilians, my nigga, like, they're not even on piss, my brother. They're just working 9 to 5 people, my nigga. Like, I can't take a man serious. He's not even my op. So when people think AC's my op, he's not my op, fam. He's a faggot. When I see him, I'm just doing him for the sake of it. He's never gonna blow his life shit, brother. He sits in his house and goes on Insta Live 20 times a day and he thinks he's gonna blow. People look at him as a joke. He's a joke, brother. He's nearly 50 and that soon. He's gonna have a fucking Vikings beard. You know what I mean? Vikings, my brother. The only thing gonna have a Vikings beard soon, fam, and have grey hairs, and he thinks that he's just gonna be sitting in that same fucking bando. He might as well come work for us. Come work for me, fam. I can put him on. Instead of shit in your same house, his girl left him. He's depressed, his girl left him, he's stressed. His girl looked after him. I even know someone that knew his girl. Like, give me no lies. Whatever, after this live, the people try to lie, but I know someone that knows his girl. This is another girl as well, but if it's people try to chat shit, I know, because I'll start backing up screenshots, and I've done that numerous amount of times, and I don't like to do that, because I'm working with big people, I ain't got time to do that no more, but he's a faggot, bro. I can't take a man that's on benefits, my brother. He's claiming benefits. He's on disabled benefits and that. And he was getting peas even when I went on live with him. Gee, I'm showing him peas that I've made. That I made it easy for him, my brother, to try to fix him up. You feel me? I could have showed him more, because after that couple hours later, I showed him more bread than what I showed him my story. I went on the live with him.
Yeah.
So, you're stunting with your girls. With your girl's money, my brother. Like, how does that make sense, bro? That's his girls. Girls on benefits. He even said it. You know, I fucked up because he said his girls on benefits on the same life. His girl does get it because the girl I know knows his girl. She's on benefits.
Okay. Let's and get on to
it. He's on benefits as well, my brother, isn't it? You see, disabled benefits, you can get probably like 8 bills to a bag for disabled benefits.
Yeah.
He's a benefit maker, my nigga. You fool me, but obviously he's got the heart of fam.
Okay, let's get on to one of the last questions about Kid Aveli. People say, yeah, they've heard him talk about the Rambo. They've seen the Rambo. But they want to know, can Kid Aveli fight in a one-to-one without any Rambo?
Bro, I'm down to fight anyone. Anybody that wants to butt me, I told man, no weapons, I'll fight man for 100 racks, bro. I will knock man up even with 5-10 bags, bro. I'll knock man up. If man wants to come, I'll fight man. Come and fight, man. I've told AC already, cool, we can go to a fight. People have inboxed me saying that they'll fund the fight, my man. It was a real account because he had about 2 to 3k account followers, yeah? He had 2 to 3k followers, yeah? But it was a real account. So I'm telling man, cool, fam, let's do this thing. Tell my man. But I told him my level that, bro, I'm not doing it for free. Man needs to get money up front. Like, what other boxes, how it goes. I'm not stupid, bro. Because you're telling me, Donnie's saying that he can't do that. He said, what does the winner get? You get me? He asked me, what does the winner get? This is the guy that said he can fund the team. He spoke to AC as well. I've said to the brother that, fam, whether the man loses, man should still get some peas up front. Because boxers still get, normal boxers still get peas up front. Am I right, my brother?
Yeah.
Exactly. And when you win, it's probably a thing for you, innit? Whatever, you probably get more or whatever. But brother, I said to him, as long as I get some peas up front, man, it's cool. If he wins, he wins. If I win, I win. I'm confident that I'll win. If he wins, he wins. If I win, I win, innit?
Yeah.
So he should take the L. If he wins, I'll take the L. It's cool. Man, whatever, innit? It's cool. You get me? Man, do our own thing, it's cool. It's only a boxing match, it's cool, but you know what I'm saying, brother? Come on, brother. Like, you know what I'm saying, brother? Like, my man just, it's a joke thing. I've told man them to fund the thing. Cool, I'll fight, man. I've been willing to do that. He's not on it with my boy. This is what I'm saying. I don't understand, brother. He wants to fight Neeks. He's only got energies for Neeks. And he said to me that I've got energy for women. Cool. What's he doing, bro? What's he doing? Bernie probably ain't even seen one rack in his life since he's been out of jail.
Okay, so let's get on to one of the last things. Obviously, all this beef is through Insta Live. All the madnesses you're seeing, all the things you're doing are through Insta Live. People want to know, what do you want to be known for on this Insta Live when it's all said and done?
Cool, my buddy. Yeah. People know me for doing road, didn't it? But certain people made false accusations of my name, tried to tarnish my name. It's cool. Certain people don't believe that. Whoever believes that is a dumb. But 061G, I'm known as a banger, my buddy. Get me? Everyone knows from Kid Kano. Old school Kid Kano, Young 28s, Young PDC, blah, 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 GG, whatever. But at the end of the day, I'm trying to be known as an artist.
Yeah.
I want to be a loved person, you feel me? Because I really do things, you feel me? And the good thing, positive things, but I really inspire a lot of youths, a lot of young G's around me. I've inspired them. Certain young G's didn't even know how to rap. No one is saying no names. When they met man, they knew how to rap. I've made them teach them how to rap. You get me? I inspired a lot of people because people might see me on Insta as this, but I don't know what's going on behind the scenes, you feel me?
Yeah.
I want to be known as a good person, as a fucking God, fam. I'm a fucking God. That's what I see myself as, bro. You get me? That I want to be known as something good, fam. You get me? Like a winner. I want to be known as a winner. This guy, look at him. He's a fucking champion. You feel me?
Yeah.
That's it, bro.
Okay, well, let us all know, where can we find your music? Anyone wants to hear some of your tunes that they ain't heard, where can we find that?
Bro, you can check that on Mixtape Madness, Link Up TV or GRM Daily.
Yeah.
On my own channel, so subscribe to my channel, 061 Official, innit? That's it. Check out the Ding Dong Ride. Got like 166k in fucking a month and a half. Technically, you might as well say 2 months now. 166k in 2 months, that's a good look. But check all my other videos, they're over 40k plus, you feel me?
Yeah.
So check my other videos, but if you want to see me tapping Kid and Benny, you're going to see it there as well. Link Up TV, you get me GRM Daily, Mixtape Madness, my own channel, called 061 Official. Make sure you check into that, and Pac-Man TV as well, check into that.
Okay, so is there anything that you feel we haven't mentioned in this interview that you want to get out there to anyone?
Right now, let me think still that we haven't mentioned. Yeah. Let me think still, but boy, just that's it, bro. But I'm not gonna lie, you've asked a good question still, you get me? Set a man fucked them, innit? That's it, bro, you get me?
Yeah. Okay, let's finish this off with a big up to Killavelli. Because right now you kept it real. Anybody who sits in that chair, they keep it real.
They keep it real.
Because a bag of man's running from that chair. So right now, I ain't got no talk for you. Real.
I respect you, brother. They get me. See one thing? I respect you, bro, innit? You see niggas like you really know about the back. You know what you're talking about. You get me? I like that, fam. You get me? Certain other things ain't like yours. Yours is the realest, fam. You get me? Niggas need to fuck with niggas like you, fam.
So respect you for sitting down, big man, and cleaning up everything anyone wanted to know.
I like that, bro.
Big up the people that watch me and support me and want to see more. And big up all the young youths out there. Like I tell you, don't watch no one. Do you and look after your family. Until the next one.